In terms of alarm analysis, I've saved the best for last. Status views are useful for checking the current state of your system, and history views display past status changes, but the incidents perform some simple but useful alarm aggregation for us. Let me point out that I'm currently viewing the online demo project, so we have some more alarms to view than our simple project can generate. Let's take an example. If there's a voltage sag on your network, it's unlikely that this will affect just a single meter. Rather, every meter in a building or below a transformer will see the same disturbance. If you're watching the status or history views, you'll be flooded with alarms, and it will be difficult to discern if this is one event or multiple, especially for a larger project. This is where incident aggregation comes in. When a new alarm is received, the alarm engine begins gathering all new alarms for a period of time into a single unit, called an incident. In this way, rather than sifting through alarms received from many meters, we see a single incident that affected multiple meters. This is exactly what we're seeing here. I have one incident here, consisting of multiple alarms. Below, I can see exactly which devices were affected by the incident. To the right, I can see the status indicator, just like the status views, as well as the duration of the entire incident. To the far right, I can view the details, just like the other history views. This page should look familiar by now, but it is giving me details for the incident as a whole. I have the alarms and events buttons on the left, which are filtered for only this incident, so I can track exactly when the individual alarms were picked up and cleared. However, the most interesting feature of the incidents is this timeline view, which we've seen links to already. This is a graphical view of the alarms in this incident in order of alarm pickup, with a line to indicate the pickup and dropout of each alarm. This gives me a simple view of the sequence of events, as well as severity, with the alarm value and alarm length. If I need more information, I can click on any alarm to access its details page. Also plotted here are the waveform pickups, pre-event cycles, and total waveform length. I can click the waveform to access its analysis window, but we'll get to that in another video. At the top of the pane, the green timeline is darker where more alarms are active. If I want to zoom in on a particular time, say when my alarms are picking up, I can drag the sliders in. When I'm done, I can reset. I also have the option to group the alarms by source instead of time, which can be useful if a single source picked up multiple times during a single incident. Now that we've seen what incidents can do, as before, let's see what incident views we have available. As with the history, recent incidents is the running list of all incidents. Power quality incidents are triggered by some type of power quality alarm, like a sag, swell, or transient. Asset monitoring and clutter incidents are both pre-configured alarm types that we'll see in a future video. Generally, you will probably stay with recent incidents. As you can see, the incident views take the next step in alarm analysis, separating one physical event in your network from another. There's a reason that the default view here is recent incidents, because this will give you the most amount of useful information in the shortest amount of time, without overloading you with every single event. I hope you can take advantage of these incident aggregations. Next, let's go back and look at those waveforms that we've been skipping. Until then, thank you.